Professional Bachelor of Computer Technology is a well-recognized degree that has been offered similarly by the universities in UK and Europe. It's meant for the working adults who aspire to earn a degree while stay in the employment. The key unique difference of the program is that it recognizes the work experiences and demonstration of the past work that can be used as part of the fulfillment of the course requirement. The program has been offered in three levels. Students who have completed the first year will be conferred the Professional Certificate of Computer Technology. If the student pursue to the second year, they may exit at the second year to earn the Professional Diploma in Computer Technology. This program also allows top-up program where students who have diploma with minimum of 2 years or more at the duration of study will be able to continue at the third year straight away. The professional program delivers both elements of academic and industrial from the way the course content is being designed to the assessment. We use innovative way of assessing students to ensure the assessment is meaningful to the needs of the industry rather than merely on the academic purpose. Students may use whatever knowledge that they have gained at the workplace to demonstrate their understanding of certain subjects that they have enrolled. Professional Bachelor of Computer Technology uses WBL, the work-based learning, as the pedagogy approach for this program. WBL has predominantly used elsewhere in America, Australia, and Europe in various institutions from the school level to the university level. For example, Middlesex University has WBL programs that are offered from bachelor level to PhD level. Victoria University has established its research center to study the significance of WBL, which has proven to benefit the employers, to increase the employees' productivity and efficiencies and overall improvement to the economic performances. Graduates will have a smaller gap in adapting to the working culture, as well as dismissal of the mismatch problem. The reason is simply because there are strong relations between what the students did at the workplace and what they learned in the course. This can be achieved through mutual involvement and participation from the industries in this program. In PBCT, there are many ways to assess the performance and competencies of the student. Among those are, number one, direct observations of the work. Assessor monitors the practical work performed by the student based on well-defined steps prescribed on the worksheet. This applies to cases where the process of problem solving is more emphasized than merely the outcome of the problem solving. Number two, in-company project. Assessor visits the workplace to inspect and assess the work activities performed by the students. This applies to projects that are restricted to the organization's work areas. Logbook or work diary. Assessment is based on the daily or weekly reported activity performed by the students at the workplace. Number four, interviewing at the work. Oral interview with the students to examine their communication and presentation skills on their experiences and understanding of their work. Number five, reflective writing or final report. Assessment on the student's ability to reminisce previous learning activities, to excogitate theories and concepts, to analyze and interpret, and to summarize in writing on a personal capacity. And students are also allowed to have portfolio. gatherings and presenting the evidences that are built throughout the students' work over a period of time in a coherent manner. PBCT has few uniqueness. Number one, it focuses to the content of the program that are essential to the subject matter, since other dimensions such as soft skills, teamwork, leadership, communication are already embedded throughout the course activities. In comparison to the MQA compliance program, professional program has less credit hours and hence can be completed in 3 years in a part-time mode. Number three, practical oriented, that every end of the year, students are expected to demonstrate a prototype based on the accumulated piece of work developed for that year. Number four, students will get early exposure to the real world problem through participation with the industrial oriented projects, and subsequently, students will be ready for the market use.